Good morning. It's the one half of the Witchy Stitchers. I'm Charlene, and this is Luna. And I'm coming to you early this morning on June 26th. Oh no, don't knock it down, dude. No, you can't knock it down. Sorry, guys. Oh, but I will rub on it and make it my own. Silly boy. Quit. You like to sit in the big window here and watch the birds and whatnot. So, yes, I'm talking to myself. I have Jinx beside me today. So, I am coming back for video number 107. And I'm early this morning. So, a little bit of life update. And my hair is wet because I literally got out of the shower, gathered up my stuff, and came in. Dalton's got his job at the rec center. I think I told you guys about that in the last video, that he was in the process of doing his certification for all of it. Don't rub on that, you'll knock it down. And he passed. He did very, very well. And so he actually started working last Monday, doing shallow water at the big rec center. And next month he will do his certification for his deep water, so then he can work at either rec center, whichever they need him at. Right now he's between 20 and 30 hours a week. It's just depending on when they need him. They've got a lot of high school and college kids, so the supervisors, I've known her since I've been swimming at the pool, and she's very fair. She's very good about dividing up the responsibilities with the kids. So, sorry guys, I have an itchy. So, other than that, for personal life, we had a major hailstorm that came through on, I think it was last Thursday and Friday. Took out the majority of our garden and did some horrible, horrible damage to our pickup. Most of the hail, I might actually have a picture of that that I can show you. There were people up the hill from us a ways that actually had hail bigger than a softball. And I had put some pictures of this. So this was the first storm that came through. And then the second storm that came through, this was about an hour afterwards when I went out. So, yeah, it was bad. There's a lot of damage in a lot of places. So, anyway, and I'm sure you saw it on the national news. So, Red Rocks, which is like, I think it's 8 miles down the road from us, had horrific, horrific hail. A lot of injuries. And do you want to say hi to the people? You guys never get to see Dobby because she never makes an appearance. Yeah, you don't want to say hi, huh? She doesn't like to be held, but she loves to be petted. Sit in the window and tell me all about the birds. Okay, so to get on with stitching, and as far as the pickup goes, we have to take it in for an estimate after the first of the month, because our insurance company, of all the repair shops in the greater Denver area, there's only three that our insurance company will allow us to take the truck to for an estimate. So, yeah, we have to go all the way into Denver for it, which is stupid, but whatever. So, for the month, this is as of last night's numbers, I am at 11,120 stitches, and for the year, I am at 85,148. So, happy with those numbers. I do have some awesome finishes to show. So I had told you guys about the scrap quilt that I was working on. I finally got it quilted last week and got it on our bed. And that is what it looks like. It came out basically 100 inches square. And those blocks are from numerous different projects that I have started over the last 30 plus years that I've been quilting. So, sorry, that came out of nowhere. Apparently we have pollen. Anyway, I got it done and I have two rows done on another one. It will be a little bit smaller. I think it's going to come out about 97 inches square just because of the difference in the size of the blocks, but that's still plenty big for our bed, so it's all good. So that was my great big finish. My other finish, so a few years ago, a friend of mine, a fellow quilty friend of mine, unfortunately she lost her mom, and her mom was a real avid quilter, and her mom had a lot of things that she didn't want or, you know, had no plans of using. And so she got a hold of me and she said, hey, would you like some of my mom's stuff? And I was like, well, at least let me pay you for it. She's like, no, I want this to go to a good home. I know that you will use this stuff. And she had several purse patterns and not a whole lot of fabric, mostly like patterns and notions and things like that. There was some fabric, but not a lot. But the patterns were amazing. And one of the things that she sent was a jelly roll, which, of course, it's not all together now, but for those of you who aren't quilters, a jelly roll, most jelly rolls, are the width of fabric, 2.5-inch strips, and there's usually 40 strips, well, it varies, 20 to 40 strips of a certain colorway. And this particular colorway is, it's like turquoises, there's some blues, here's a couple of them. And I've had it all this time, I'm like, what am I going to do with this? Like, most of my quilts, I either do log cabins, which are 1.5 inches, so that would be a waste of fabric because these are 2.5-inch strips. Or, again, the scrappy quilts, but I don't usually use a 2.5-inch strip. So I've been pondering all this time. Well, when I was downstairs looking for, because I'm still looking for my Winter Queen, my Winter Mirabilia, she's downstairs somewhere. She's just hiding. When I was downstairs looking for her, I came across several patterns that I had printed out a long time ago. This one, I think, is clear back to, I think, 07, 08. I don't even know when it was. We were still living on the Western Slope, so I know it's been at least 10 years. So, anyway, I had printed this out, and I came across it, and I was like, oh. And the bag that I have that I keep in the pickup with my for my travel projects is huge. It is a huge, huge bag. And it's too big to sit comfortably on the console and to stand up next to my purse. Basically the transfer case between the console and the radio and stuff. It's just too big. And so I've been using one that I've been kind of back and forth using for a grocery bag because we have to have our own grocery bags now. There's a fee if you want to use the bags at the stores. And I don't really like it, and it's canvas and it gets dirty really easy, and I'm not a fan. So I kept telling Preston, I said, I need to make me a new bag. We'll make it. Okay, well, guess what? So I found this pattern, and I used that jelly roll. So one side, other side, and then the bottom. And then I had enough of this fabric left, and I've had this fabric for years. And normally I don't put white on the inside of my bags because they do get dirty, but I thought this is perfect. So here we go. So that was my other finish. And I've got enough, as you could see from those leftover strips, that Morgan really liked it too. And so I'm going to get busy and get her a bag made. So she will have it. Okay. So, best for last. So you guys know that I was working on my Mermaid of the Pearls to finish for Morgan for her birthday. And my goal was to get it done so I could get it sent to her in time so she could get it into Hobby Lobby or Michael's or wherever she decides to take it and get it framed. And yesterday, I finished it. So, Her in All of Her Splendor. I am really happy with how she turned out. And Dalton came up with a really cool idea for the framing of her. So to put her in a square frame, but then to have them cut the mat as an oval to highlight her and maybe to help with our very short edging on the side. And I suggested it to Morgan when I sent her the picture, and she was like, yeah, that sounds cool. So I will get it sent off. I've got to iron it, and then I'm going to roll it so it's ready to go when she takes it into the framer. And hopefully they can get it back in time for her birthday. So those are my finishes for the last 2 weeks since I've seen you guys. Most of my focus has been on working on her in the mornings. So now I need to find a new focus piece, which I have one I will show you. But I also have something else to show. And I will show it at the end because it has nothing to do with stitching. But I know that several of you will appreciate my news. So, moving on, I worked on 6 different things. So I will start with the first thing I worked on, which is, and of course I forgot the cover picture, but you guys know what it looks like. I've shown it to you before. This is the Field of Poppies. It's a Van Gogh piece. And I stitch on it here at home because it's on 18 count and I have trouble seeing 18 count in the truck. So I have the first 2 rows, so the first 2 bits of 10 done all the way across until you get to right here. I'm hoping that I can get, well, those won't get done tonight, but they'll be done by the time I come back and see you again. Tonight, since it's the 26th, I have an actual piece that I'll work on, which I will be showing you in my plans. So that's where I got to on my Field of Poppies. And then I finally got my Temperature Quaker cut up. I was only a few days behind, but I was holding out for some changes in the temperatures. And yeah, no. But this week, believe it or not, we're finally going to get into the 80s now that it's the end of June. It's been such a weird year. And no, nothing is ironed. So this is the whole piece. And I had 3 colors this last week. And today is going to be probably this color right here, and then the next 3 days we're supposed to be in the 80s, so I will get a new color. So I'm super excited about that. Did you come to visit too, Snoopy? I just got a whole menagerie of pets in here. The next thing I worked on, and I kind of turned her into my travel piece, because she's on 14 count, and I can work on her while I'm waiting for Dalton to get off work, and that's the April Fairy. And my plan is, hey Luna, did you come back? My plan is to work across the top, similar to what Sarah from Stitch and Mommy does, work across the top, finishing off blocks of 10, kind of like I'm doing on the Field of Poppies. But my goal is to get all the way across the top on this one. And I'm working in some, I think they're ugly yellows. They're like the goldenrod yellows. Not a fan, but maybe that's what makes up her hair, right? So, all right. So since I saw you guys last, I was going to try and get this done for Preston for Father's Day. And I was really struggling to read the pattern. So this, as most of you guys know, Morgan and I belong to a group called Post Crossing. And so we've sent postcards and received postcards from all over the world. And this postcard I actually received back in 22. And I'll hold it back here. So it's a cross stitch pattern, and it is from basically Gamma is who does the postcards. And I have several of these. I've made one that's like a bouquet of flowers. So this is how much I got done on this one. And I had to do a conversion, and I was really fortunate. I found a conversion online for most of the threads, and so then I just improvised on the rest of them. But to transfer them from theirs to DMC. But this weekend, I finally had a chance to step into Office Max, and I was able to get quite a few of my hard-to-read patterns blown up. So that was really nice. So now I can put him back in the to-get-done pile. This one, I started this one, if memory serves me right, I either started this one in 96 or 97, maybe 98. In fact, I'm going to go with 97 or 98 because I think we were living in Grand Junction at the time when I found this at Hobby Lobby. So this is a dimensions kit. And I had started this for my mom and dad. They built a new house on their place, moved out of their old farmhouse into a new house. And I was going to make it for them. And I ended up obviously not, which I'm kind of glad now that I didn't, because I know that all of the stitching that I made for my folks over all the years has been destroyed. And so, I mean, I'm glad that I kept this one for us. So anyway, that's where I'm at on it. And when I picked it up this week, I did some backstitch, I finished off some of the thistles, and then I filled in all these half stitches, and then I did some backstitching on the mailbox. And the thing of it is that there's not a lot left to do. A good portion of these, of this, is half stitches. So in theory, this should go fast. I don't know why it's not done. It's very pleasant to work on. I just haven't got it finished. But it's definitely one of my oldest whips. And the last thing that I worked on, because yesterday was the 25th, I worked on my cupcakes. No, I did not get that cupcake done. I thought I was going to be able to, but I didn't. I realized that I was out of one of my threads. So I was working on this guy right here. And I found the thread. I had one in my box of threads. But I ended up putting in over 300 stitches, so I thought I did pretty well. But so all I have left to do on this is I have, I think, three more sparkles to put in. And I need to finish the half stitches down here at the bottom, like is on this, these. A shadow. There it is. And then I need to finish backstitching the red part of the cupcake too. So it will definitely be a finish the next time I work on it. And then I haven't decided which one. I don't know where I'm going to go next. I've been pondering, because this one's really close, I don't have a whole lot of jumping. I've been pondering finishing all of this in here, because then it, you know, gives me better access to these. This one is super close, that I can come down and start on the gingerbread man and work my way down. I don't know. I'm pondering. So it will come back out on the 25th of July and get some more left. So that is my whips for the month. My plans, want to work some on my quilts. I still need to get some progress done on my father-in-law's quilt. And I'd, like I said, I would still like to get the next crab quilt done. Yes, I'm talking to myself, I know. I want to get Morgan's tote bag made, which I'm hoping will be this week. Are you gonna say hi? Can you lift your nose up and say hi? I know, yes, I know. How come you're wet? Are you messing with a cat? Silly dog. I want to keep current with my temperature Quaker, which is going really well. And that way I can post at the end of the month on my actual Facebook page. The other thing that I want to work on, because today is the 26th. Lay down, I'm almost done. I want to work on my war pony. And I was super excited when I went into Office Max because I was able to get blown up three or four patterns that I've been wanting to work on. So I'm excited about that. So, oh, this thing is such a bear to take out of here. It's huge. So this is War Pony by Lori Prindle. And I have been trying to work on it the 26th of every month in honor of my dad. Because his birthday was the 26th of August. And that is where I'm at so far. Little to no progress, but it will get some love tonight. We're sitting and watching the news and whatnot. We don't have quite as early of a morning. We had to be up and going at 3:30 this morning, so we went to bed a little bit earlier. Anyway, the next thing, so I don't have a focus piece now. So I'm going to pick two focus pieces, and this doesn't mean these are the only two I'm going to work on. These are just the two that I will give an abundance of love to for the month of July. So, for those of you that participate in Joan in July, I am going to bring out her Wizard's View, which is out of the Beautiful Cross Stitch book. And I won't get this one done in July. But the other cool thing too is that I can still do my Mill Hill Mania, or you know, Mill Hill Monday, because I can work on the beads. This is where I'm at on him. And he has holy cow amounts of beads in his cloak and in the border. And so yeah, I want to bring him out. Like I said, I won't get him done in July. I mean, I counted just rough ballpark estimate, and there's over 13,000 stitches left in him. So, yeah, and that doesn't count the back stitch. And I mean, anybody who's ever done a Joan knows that the back stitch is almost as much as the project itself. And then I think my main focus piece is going to be My Necessity by Heartstring Samplers. Samplery. And I started this one in February a year ago. I think it was February. Hang on. I finally remembered these notes too. 1/21 of 22. It wasn't that in January. So our wedding anniversary is in August. This year will be 32 years. So I want to work on that. This is a piece of fabric that I dyed myself, and it's just, I love it. It's a mess, just like me. So, and as you can see, my very meager start. So my goal is to turn this one into my everyday stitch like I had with the mermaid. So, and those are my plans as far as my new totals, which isn't, I mean, anything exciting. So as of yesterday, I am at 104 whips. So not anywhere near where I wanted to be this time of the year, but I'm happy with it. So now my personal news. So if you don't want to stick around for that, thank you for staying and listening to me babble. For those who want to know. So those of you who have been with us for a while know that I'm a published author. I have been published since 2012. And when I first got published, I had a publisher. Long story short, I no longer have a publisher. I published my second novel on my own, and it did very well. And I had to wait until the rights to my first novel were released back to me, that they were mine. And they have been. And last week, I was able to finally finalize everything with Amazon for both my Kindle and for my paperback copies of my first book. It does have a new cover on it. So this is now available on Amazon, like I said, either in paperback or in Kindle, along with the second one. It is a series. And the third one we're shooting for to be released in the fall. It's about 2/3 of the way done. I am meeting with a designer to do my cover, hopefully next week, to get everything finalized and get it designed so we're ready to go. And I stepped in to our local bookstore, and we are going to shoot for a book signing either the 22nd or the 29th of July. So I don't know the dates yet. I'm supposed to get in touch with them this week and get everything taken care of. So if you are anywhere near here and you are interested in coming, keep an eye out. And I will be posting it on our Witchy page and on Instagram as well for people to know. So I think that is all of my news. I will be back to you. Looks like I will be back on the 10th of July. So that will be 2 weeks. I don't know what Morgan has going on for sure this week, availability for doing her video on Sunday. But she hasn't said there was anything going on, so it should be on track. But I think that is pretty much all of my news. It's been a busy week. Lots going on. 2 weeks, actually, I guess. So I will see you on the 10th. I hope you guys have a great week. And just remember, be kind. Bye.